everybody, welcome back. This lesson is about the ALARA philosophy and how to protect yourself from the hazardous effects of radiation. So how can you protect yourself from radiation? In a weird way, it's actually really similar to protecting yourself from a tornado. With a tornado, you would minimize your time near windows in unsafe areas. You would maximize your distance from the tornado if you can. And last of all, you would shield yourself from the tornado by hiding under something sturdy. Incredibly, these principles of tornado safety are exactly the same as the cardinal rules of radiation protection: time, distance, and shielding. Time, distance, and shielding are all radiation protection mechanisms used to implement the ALARA philosophy. So what is ALARA? ALARA is actually an acronym that stands for As Low As Reasonably Achievable. It's a general philosophy about radiation protection, and it's the law. ALARA is defined by the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, or NRC, like this, quote, making every reasonable effort to maintain exposures to ionizing radiation as far below the dose limits as practical, consistent with the purpose for which the licensed activity is undertaken. That's not as complicated as it sounds. The ALARA rule simply means that the radiation dose to the occupational worker should be kept as low as reasonably achievable, not as low as possible, but as low as we can, while still providing quality medical imaging to our patients. And as stated in the law, the responsible and legal use of radiation should result in occupational doses that are far below the legal limits. The cardinal rules of radiation protection are the principal ways in which we execute or apply the ALARA rule. Each cardinal rule affects the radiation dose to a worker in a very predictable way. We'll start with time. A person's time in a radiation field should be minimized because the relationship between exposure time and radiation dose is directly proportional. As time goes up, the radiation dose goes up by the same amount. As time goes down, the radiation dose goes down by the same amount. For example, let's say a healthcare professional assists in an exam that takes 4 minutes of fluoroscopy time, and they receive an absorbed dose of 60 microgray. If the exposure time were reduced by half, the worker's dose would also have been reduced by half, down to 30 microgray. If the fluoroscopy time had been increased by 50%, the worker's dose would have also increased by 50% up to 90 microgray. This is why worker schedules should give consideration to the amount of time spent in areas with higher occupational doses. Fluoroscopy, surgery, and portable radiography are all associated with higher radiation doses, since the operator must be near the radiation field. When possible, worker schedules should be balanced so that no one spends an excessive amount of time on these assignments. Distance is the second cardinal rule of radiation protection. An operator should always maximize their distance between themselves and the radiation source. In other words, increasing the distance decreases the radiation dose. In fact, distance has an enormous influence on radiation dose because it follows the inverse square law. In radiography, the most significant source of occupational dose is actually the patient. The operator should never be in the primary beam, and tube leakage is minimal, so scatter radiation from the patient is of greatest concern. For that reason, the operator should increase their distance from the patient during the exposure. Distance from the X-ray tube is not a major concern. Here's an example of how the inverse square law applies to occupational dose. If we increase our distance from the source by a factor of 3, our dose decreases by a factor of 3 squared, which is 9. If we reduce our distance by a factor of 4, dose increases by a factor of 4 squared, which is 16. For more complex math, we'd need to use the inverse square law formula. But for the purpose of this lesson, just understand that increasing your distance from the patient is a very simple and effective way of decreasing your dose. The last cardinal rule of radiation protection is shielding. Sometimes it's impossible to leave the room or even step away from the radiation source. When that happens, shielding can be used to reduce the radiation dose. There are many types of shielding devices. Aprons, gloves, leaded glasses, and thyroid shields are commonly worn by operators. Even walls and doors of X-ray rooms have shielding to protect people outside of the room. The amount of radiation dose reduction depends on the shielding material and the thickness of the shield. Lead is more effective than other materials because it's very dense and has a very high atomic number. More lead results in more attenuation and a lower radiation dose. Lead shielding is very effective at reducing occupational dose from scatter radiation. Depending on the KVP in use and the thickness of the shield, lead shielding can reduce occupational dose by 85% up to 99%. So in summary, the general philosophy and federal law for radiation protection is guided by the ALARA rule, which stands for as low as reasonably achievable. The ALARA rule can be accomplished by exercising the three cardinal rules of radiation protection: time, distance, and shielding.
If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.